Hello and welcome to your class of economics. Now today we are going to have a revision of first chapter that is taken from macroeconomics, and that is the introduction. So let's begin. Macroeconomics. Now this word macro, it got its origin from Greek word that is known as makros. Okay, now this macros means in English large. Okay, and when we talk about the means in the context of macro large, in the context of economy, we say it is an economy as whole. So whenever the large word comes, it related to in relation to macroeconomics, we talk about the economy as a whole. Means here we are not going to study about a single firm, single individual, or single household or single industry. We are talking about the all the means households, individuals, and whatever comes under the economy. So it's a large number. It's not a single firm or single industry. Okay. So now we have the definition of macroeconomics. Macroeconomics. Macroeconomics deals with the problem of, deals with the problems and issues. Okay. Now it's dealing with, deals economic problems. It deals with economic problems and economic issues. Okay. Now, when we talk about the economic problem and economic issues, and we are studying macroeconomics, it is taken on the level of economy as a whole. Okay. At the level of as whole. Okay. So, we can say macroeconomics is a branch of economics which deals with the economic problem and economic issues at the level of economy as a whole. Okay. So, this is the definition of macroeconomics. Now, we study the difference between macroeconomics and macroeconomics. Okay, so difference between macro and micro. Okay, so first difference between on the basis of study. So on the basis of study, we can say the problem of choice and problem of scarcity. So, on the basis of study, when we talk about the microeconomics, micro level, we talk about the single problem, means single person's problem or single individual problem of scarcity and choice. Okay. But when we talk about the macroeconomics, okay, at the level of macro, this number is large. Okay. Here there will be not a single person, there will won't be a single person, there will be many persons. We can say it will be many persons or it will be many individual or many household or many firms are there, and which comes under the macroeconomics. So it is not the problem of for only single person. Like in microeconomics, it will be a problem for a large number of person, okay, or a large number of household, consumer, producer, whatever are there, in comes under the economy. Okay, so we will be talking about the economy as a whole. Okay, now we are going to have a second topic. Economic variables. Now, economic variables are different in microeconomics and are different in macroeconomics. In microeconomics, the economic variables are producer, supply, and consumers demand. So when we study the microeconomics, we study about the producer supply and consumers demand. But when we study macroeconomics, macro, we study the aggregate demand. And aggregate supply means this is the sum of all the demands. Means we can say, we take for example, we take the example as in market. Okay, so their number of consumers are there, those are demanding. So we take aggregate, we sum up all their demands and we take as an aggregate demand. And supply, we means number of producers are there. It means we are not talking about the only one producer, we are talking about the numbers of producer, and we take their sum of output, which is where they do supply in the market. We take aggregation on a, we sum up their supply and we take it as an aggregate supply. Okay, so now we move to the third topic. Now, that is third topic, economic agents. Now, economic agents. Here it refers to the single individual and institution. We can say like individual is taken under micro, because this individual or a single individual or single household deals with their problem. Means we can say that the deals, they are concerned about themselves. They are in the means we can say they want to satisfy their or they want to profit maximization. They want profit maximization in the case of individual. Okay, they are the single person, those who are taking the decisions. But in macroeconomics, institutions come. Okay, now under macroeconomics, these institutions are RBI, that is Reserve Bank of India, that is also called as Central Bank or Mother Bank of India. Then TRAI and SEBI. Now, for the betterment of the or social welfare at a large scale or maximized level, we can say these institutions take the decision so that it could help or it could do the social welfare. Okay, so when we talk about the macro, the institution who takes the decision so that it could be social welfare can be done. And when we talk about the macroeconomics, we talk about the individual. Here individuals are there. It can be individual household, individual person, individual firm or individual industry, which are going to take the decision for their benefits or for their maximum satisfaction, or you can say maximum profit. Okay. So now we talk about the fourth point. Okay, so fourth point is degree of aggregation. Now degree of aggregation is limited in the microeconomics, and it is more in macroeconomics. So macroeconomics, when we talk about the macroeconomics, equilibrium, it studies the equilibrium of an industry. Means a industry which is different numbers of producer are there, and they are producing only a particular kind of commodity. In that case, it studies the equilibrium of that particular industry. And in macroeconomics, in macro, we can say it tries to study the equilibrium of the whole economy, and it's talk about the whole, all, each and everybody. Okay, so it work as an equilibrium, studies the equilibrium of all as economy as whole. Okay, so now we talk about the fifth point, that is different sets of assumptions. Okay, different sets of assumptions means which is constant in a micro, means in micro, which is constant. Some variables are constant. Okay, now see, different assumptions are there to be in the microeconomics. We study like this. There are some which variables are taken as in constant in micro may not be constant in a macro, and which are constant in macro may not be constant in the micro. Okay, so again let me speak that difference of sets of assumptions means the variables which are taken as constant or which are assumed to be constant in microeconomics may not be constant in macroeconomics, and the same way the variables which are assumed to be constant in the microeconomics, in the macroeconomics, may not be constant in microeconomics. So now we are moving to the fifth point. Now the sixth point, again, the central issues. Okay, so in micro level, when we talk about the microeconomics or we see the microeconomics level, the micro level is allocation of allocation of resources. Means when we study microeconomics, there will be a issues of central issue will be allocation of resources. Okay, then at a macro level, the problem or the central issue would be determination of overall level of output. Means we have to see the how much output is being produced in the economy. Okay, how much output is being there. So now we talk about the seventh point, that is method of study. Now at the macro level, we study about the general equilibrium analysis. Means here we are analyzing about the all the market which are there in the comes under the Indian economy. Okay, and when we talk about the macroeconomics study, that is partial equilibrium analysis. Okay, so let me write. Seventh will be method of study. That is, at macro level, it is general equilibrium analysis. Okay, I'm at
micro. In micro level, it is partial. Okay, now this general means all market, and this partial means about single market or one market. Okay, when we talk about the partial, it will be containing only one market, and when we talk about the macro level, that is general equilibrium analysis, means all market. Okay, now the 8th point. Now that is 8th point, method of study. Okay, sorry. Micro and micro paradox. Okay, so now we see this micro and macro paradox. It is very simple, okay? Now, which is logical in macroeconomics may not be logical in macro. Okay, means the things which may be logical in macro may not be logical at macro, and the things which is logical means which is logical in macroeconomics may not be logical in micro. Okay, it is very simple. So micro and macro paradox, it is very simple. That is, which may be logical in macroeconomics may not be, sorry, which may be logical in microeconomics may not be logical in macroeconomics, and which is logical in macroeconomics may not be logical in microeconomics. So thank you, and we will meet up with the next class of revision. Till then, bye.